Welcome to Heartfully Creating. Today's needle felting adventure is my first turtle. This is just more about sharing what I did and a little bit about how I did. You need some felt, felting needle, finger guards, roving wool, which is that loose puffy stuff that looks like a cotton ball. It's actually from a, well, in this case, it's from a sheep. And finger guards, and about a at least one inch piece of styrofoam or a foam that's kind of dense so you don't poke the table. So I didn't start from the very beginning, I apologize again. But all the shapes are formed by, you form them, and they're sort of the shape that you want, and then I just start poking them. In this case, I had formed the legs and started attaching them separately to the belly. The spots were formed separately, and then I started poking them. And when you needle felt, like I said, I'm just learning, the more you poke, the denser it gets. The fibers grab onto each other. So if you want to make something soft and squishy, use a really soft roving wool, such as merino. I've learned that the lower the number is, the softer it is. This is just sample wool I've got in through Amazon.ca. So this is a really, really quick video, so I'm not going to go into a lot of detail, but I decided to add some glue around the shell because I didn't like, it was kind of boring. So you just sort of treat it like a thread and take a longer fiber and just poke around. Just like I did, there's the belly I attached up separately. But the mouth and the eyes, I just use a tiny bit of black wool and sort of like a thread, basically twisted it into a thread. His face does look a little fuzzy right there, but it works. You can just poke with the needle a tiniest bit of black. This turtle is only maybe 3 inches long. So to form the mouth and the eyes, and there you have it. So hopefully you're inspired to try needle felting. It's a pretty fun thing to do. Especially for me when my hands feel extra tired, like I can't deal with, I love clay, that's my big number one three-dimensional art making medium these days, but I have to say because of my muscle weakness, it is hard some days to work with that stuff. So felting is a good colorful three-dimensional option to make something, because I always, every day, like I said, I'm not normal in my head if I'm not creating something. So, all right, hope you enjoyed that. And don't forget to check out our Facebook Heartfully Creating page to like, and there you actually can share photos of your work if you're trying anything that we're showing here or not. I would love to see it. So, hope to see you soon. Don't forget to like, share, and subscribe. Have a good day.